Our next caller is Gunner from Washington.
What's up, Gunner? How can we help you?
How's it going? I had a hernia surgery about a year ago. I was cleared to exercise. I've been exercising since. I'm running anabolic right now, and I plan to run aesthetic after that at both those programs. And squats and deadlifts are very prominent in that program. And when I do those, I notice flare-ups, like where I had that surgery at. I'm kind of pretty itchy there for a couple of days. Just kind of unnecessary pain in that area. I think it's due to the big load, kind of with weight in those exercises. And I'm curious what you guys would recommend switching out for those two.
Yeah, okay, so you don't want to mess with hernia surgery.
If that
tears again, it's going to be I'm sure the recovery was probably a pain in the butt and it took a while. So
that being said, we don't need to abandon the exercise.
No, here's the deal. This is somewhere where I would if you were my client, I'd have you go back to the doctor and I would talk to them and get their clearance on what you can and can't do. Because you're feeling something post-exercise, that tells me that either the way you're bracing or maybe even the way that the procedure was done to repair your hernia. Did they add any mesh material or did they just sew up what was open?
Yeah, they did add mesh. And when I exercise now, like I've been doing, I'm about halfway through anabolic. I've been doing Bulgarian split squats with like lighter weight and kind of doing time under tension. And then I did like kettlebell Romanian deadlifts yesterday.
Okay.
And no pain.
Yeah, good call.
Yeah, I would go, again, check with your doctor because sometimes the itchiness is literally where the mesh attaches to the muscle and it could be just part of the healing process. Things are moving. Not necessarily a bad thing, but I'm not a doctor and I would clear that with your doctor because if it tears again, the second time around is going to be worse than the first time around. This is not something you want to mess around with.
So I'm with Sal. I obviously doctor stuff first, but then I also wouldn't abandon the movements. I would just lighten the load and slow down the tempo and really concentrate on bracing my core and keeping my spine nice and neutral through the movement and just master the technique of the movement. And even if you're following something like anabolic, which I know is a strength focused first phase, don't worry about always loading the bar more and more weight. Get more into perfecting the movement. I love your decision to go to the Bulgarian split squats. Yeah. I think that's a great call. But there's just so much value in the squat and the deadlift. And we don't want to, because basically if we say you're going to move away from it now, are we just going to accept for the rest of your life you'll never be able to squat or deadlift again? It's like, no, I don't think you want that. I don't want that for you. And so let's first get some clearance from the doctor to make sure we're all good to go. But then let's just start from the ground up and move real slow.
Yeah, just keep that load way down until you know for sure. Like, you can feel when it's healed up and things are sort of operating back to normal. And so like the Bulgarian split squats and like kind of doing the unilateral type training is going to benefit you quite a bit. You're still going to build muscle and you're still going to build a lot more stability and support for when, you feel like you're now ready to then start stacking the load on. So there's nothing wrong with, staying in that type of mentality for a while.
Yeah. And you might be surprised, like you might go to the doctor and the doctor might say, oh, well, that's normal where we attached the mesh to the muscle
and stuff.
Scar tissue is changing and growing and, stretching. And that's just a normal process of, your body adapting to this particular procedure. So they might just say that to you. But nonetheless, get clearance. I've worked with people who've re-injured a hernia, and I'm going to tell you right now, you don't want to do that.
Yeah,
it's not worth it.
Okay, great. Thanks, guys.
No problem, Gunner.
Awesome.
I know a guy that kept re-injuring a hernia, and obviously your gut starts to poke through the hole, and he would push it back in with his hand. Anyway, it got so bad, it pinched off a piece of his intestine, which died. He had to go in and get it removed. Yeah. Oh, hernias can be really bad.
Yeah,
they could be really, really bad things.
Serious.
Yeah, to the point where they can become almost life-threatening. Or you just keep re-injuring this area, and then you're left with this kind of permanent issue.
And it's such a a weak link right there. Like, it's susceptible to, it's easily, torn once it's done it once. So it's like it's just one of those things. You want to make sure it's really healed up before you start adding the intensity back.
Now, given, say, the doctor does clear him and he's fine, this is an example, though, of why I would not want to abandon those movements. It's just, and this is where you can play with things like tempo and isometrics. Like, nothing stops you from... Okay, obviously he does normal movements, getting up and out of a chair and stuff like that. And so load the bar really, really light and, you know, pause at the bottom and pause midway through the movement and grip the floor and then squeeze and contract at the end and, you know, slow it way down on the eccentric portion of the exercise. So lots of different ways for you to play with it. And then unilateral, like Justin was alluding to, I mean, do some single leg deadlifts and get really good at that and perfect the movement. We're always so hung up on moving weight on the bar as our sign of we're getting better and stronger. It's like you absolutely do not always need to do that. And here's a perfect example of somebody who, instead of us, because the natural thing that someone at 24 wants to do is go like, okay, should I just stop squatting? And then I go leg press really heavy.
Yeah.
You know, because I feel okay leg pressing. So let's go stack six
plates. By the way, the leg press would be the worst possible thing.
I know.
That's even worse
but
than
I mean,
squat.
That's how they would think though, right? I mean, that's a client would think, or go to some machine leg extension and stack the plates on there. It's just like, we want to just go heavy and do something that we feel safer doing. It's like, no, what we should do is just really lighten the load in those movements, because, you know, being able to hinge at the hip, you know, and squat down parallel
or below. That's a fundamental human movement.
Yeah, we don't, and at 24, I don't want to give up on you having that.